Good morning. Thank you, Kason. Welcome to worship at Cape Fear Presbyterian Church. We are glad that you are here this morning. If you haven't already done so, please take the red fellowship pads, which are parked in the pew rack on the center aisle. If you would add your name to the page, add the date to the page if it's not there when it comes to you. If you're worshiping with us for the first time, we'd appreciate you leaving some contact info in the form of a phone number or an email address or a postal address just so we can follow up with you and thank you for worshiping with us today. When it gets to the end of the pew, pass it on back and you can take a peek at who's sitting on the pew with you and perhaps learn the name of somebody new and be able to greet them personally at the conclusion of our service. And then if you'll do me a favor and just leave them here on the center aisle, one of our deacons will collect those after the service. Direct your attention to the announcement section of the bulletin. If you'll pull that out, I want to highlight just a few things going on in the life of the church this week. Coming up today, immediately following worship at 12:10, the deacons will meet in the meeting room. And then at 1:30, strengthening of the church team will meet in that room as well. So a couple of meetings coming up after church today. If you're a deacon or part of the SOC team, pay attention to that. Coming up this week on Tuesday, our Young at Heart will meet. That's our senior fellowship group. They'll meet at 11 o'clock here in our fellowship hall for food, fun, and fellowship. Our guest speaker this week is Gannon Medwick. Gannon is the chief meteorologist for WECT and Fox Wilmington. So he's going to come talk all about the weather and probably give us a heads up on hurricane preparation. So lots of great things going on Tuesday. Be sure you come and join us. Saturday, we're going to have a work day here at the church from 9 to 12. We're going to do some stuff inside and out to beautify and freshen up our facilities. So come ready to work. Bring your work clothes. Bring some gloves. We're working on a list of projects. The scouts will be helping us out with that as well. So come and join us next Saturday from 9 to 12. Next week, we're going to collect our sensibility offering. So if you've got a bank that looks like this at home and you've got some change in it, bring that back with you next Sunday. If you don't have a bank like this, there are some outside of this door and probably outside of that door as well. So take it home with you and add some change to it as the week progresses. This goes to our presbytery to help with the Presbyterian Hunger Program. So we'll collect those next week. We're in the process of updating our church directory. We're going to be publishing this probably in the next month or so. We have some pages from the previous directory. We've enlarged them. They're on the desk across from the office. What we'd like you to do is to go through, when you pass by that, take a look at your information. Make any corrections that need to be done. There's some pens there if you'll just mark stuff out or write stuff nearby. Please write legibly or as legibly as you can. Otherwise, we'll just call you and get some more of that information. Also, if you would do us a favor and leave your birthday information there. It doesn't have to be the year. I know people are particular about that. Just the month and the day, just so that we can make sure that we've got all that information correct in our church database. So there's a space next to the column on the side for adding birthday information. We would appreciate that. I want to thank Chris Tingley and Bud Thacker for restriping our parking lot this week. You may have noticed that when you came in this morning. If not, take a look when you go out. We did some modifications of a couple of spots as well to make ingress and egress out of the breezeway more easier. So thanks to Chris and thanks to Bud for coordinating that this week. Any other announcements? Who? I mentioned it. Wake up, Wayne, wake up. We are doing a work day next week, right? Did I mention that? Okay. Saturday, 9 to 12. Elena heard it. All right. Any other announcements? They are. Yes, the scouts will be here helping us. That's right. Yep, our Cub Scout troop. If there aren't any other announcements, we will continue with our worship. Please stand as you are able. Let us call ourselves to worship by using the call to worship found in your bulletin. I will be the left side, that will be the right side. Let everything that is praise our God. Let all people praise God.
Let the oceans praise God.
Let mountains and hills praise God.
Let the trees and the forests praise God.
Let wild animals praise God. Let all people come to this place, and together let us praise God. Thank you. Beloved, we are God's children because of the love God has for us, yet we sometimes fail to respond to God's outpouring of love. Let us confess our sins together by using the prayer found in your bulletin. Change is hard. We think we know things, and it becomes very difficult to let go of old ideas and embrace new ones. In a world that is ever changing, we want consistency. In a world where uncertainty appears at every turn, we want to know what will happen next. Yet you, loving God, challenge us, and you call us to new ways of seeing the world around us. Forgive us our hard-heartedness. Forgive us our resistance to change. Forgive us our judgments based on old ideas. Forgive us our rejection of the new things. You, O God, are forever bringing into our lives. Refresh us with your new and eternal spirit. Amen. Friends, know that our God always loves us and invites us to see things anew. Whenever you open your heart to God, God is already there, making us into new and wondrous creatures. Thanks be to God. Since God has forgiven us in Christ, let us forgive one another. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with each and every one of you. Please turn to those around you and greet one another with signs and words of peace. While you all are getting settled, I'd like to invite the children to come forward. Meet me at the chancel steps. Come on up. Come on, Joey. Come on, Kiki. How's everybody today? Good? Christian, you all right? Good. Glad to hear it. All right, what is this? An elephant. That's right. Let me tell you the story about the blind people and the elephant. Six blind people were asked to figure out what an elephant looks like by feeling different parts of the elephant's body. One blind person felt a leg and said the elephant is like a pillar. The second felt the tail and said the elephant is like a rope. The third felt the trunk and said that the elephant was like a tree branch. The fourth felt the ear and said that the elephant is like a hand fan, one of those things that you fan yourself with, piece of paper on the end of a stick. The fifth felt the belly of the elephant and said that the elephant is like a wall. And the sixth felt the tusk and said that the elephant is like a solid pipe. Are any of these people correct in describing this elephant? But they are in a way. None of them can see the whole elephant, so they're reacting to what they feel and what they see. Or what they feel. Only God could make something as wonderful and as complicated as an elephant, because in God's wisdom, God made them all. God made all the creatures on the earth. Most of us are not blind. It's still hard for us to see everything that God has created in the air, in the sea, on land, but we can praise God for creating the world and us and for giving us food and air to breathe. Amen? As you guys go home today and in the week ahead, I want you to think about all of the amazing creatures that God has made, from the smallest to the biggest. Whenever you encounter something, think about it. Think about it and give thanks to God. All right? Let's pray. Most gracious and holy God, we thank you for creating elephants and flowers and bugs. We thank you for all of it because you made those things. And so we are grateful. We're also grateful that you made us. We're grateful that you provide food for us. We're grateful that you give us air to breathe. Let us, in everything we do, praise you because we are thankful. And all of God's children together said, amen. Thank you, boys and girls. Our primary text this morning is Psalm 148. You can find that in the Bible on the page numbers listed in your bulletin. I ask that you would just find that and then stick your hand in it or stick a bookmark in it. We will get to that later on within the body of the sermon. Though we're only 4 months in, 2016 has already been a year rife with sadness in the music world, with the loss of some very talented, legendary musicians. Among them, David Bowie, Glenn Frey, Maurice White, Merle Haggard, and just this week, the artist simply known as Prince. While there certainly are stylistic and generational differences among them, there's no denying that each of these individuals, in their own right, leave behind a musical legacy. Songwriting, singing, instrumental chops, these are all creative endeavors, much like painting, writing, photography, pottery, cooking, gardening, and a host of others. The tools and the results may be different, but each develops from an innate sense of creativity, a desire to create. Call it left-brained or right-brained, it makes no difference. Everyone is creative in some capacity. And these abilities are given to us by God. Think about it. We are created in the very image of our Creator. We are descended from God, children of God. And God is the very definition of creativity with a capital C. From nothing, God brought this great, big, wonderful world, including you and me, into existence. There is a Latin phrase that beautifully captures this creative process. Ex nihilo. Ex nihilo means out of nothing. To experience this firsthand, we need look no further than the first sentence of the first chapter of the first book of the Bible, Genesis 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was without shape and empty, and darkness was over the surface of the watery deep. But the Spirit of God was moving over the surface of the water. God speaks the universe into existence. With the utterance of his voice, creation takes form. Chaos yields to order. Light eclipses darkness, and emptiness fills with life. Preacher and author Rob Bell describes it this way. Stars and fish, and earth and birds, and animals and oceans, all in the endless process of becoming. A tree produces fruit that contains seeds that will eventually grow new trees that will produce new fruit that contains more seeds to make more new trees. This world is exploding with life and beauty and complexity and diversity. All of it making more, becoming and evolving in such a way that tomorrow will be different from today because it's all headed somewhere. Nothing is set in stone or static. The whole thing is in motion, flush with vitality and pulsing with creative energy. End quote. Psalm 148 likewise affirms the marvel of creation by reminding us that all creation echoes the presence of God. Let's read it together, responsively. I'll read the odd-numbered verses, and I invite you to respond with the even-numbered verses. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights.
Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts.
Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars.
Praise him in the highest heavens, and you waters above heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created.
He established them forever and ever. He fixed their bounds, which cannot be passed.
Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps.
Fire and hail, snow and frost, stormy wind, fulfilling his command.
Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars.
Wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds.
Kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth.
Young men and women alike, old men.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His glory is above earth and heaven.
He is praised above the horn of his people. Praise for all his faithful, for people who have to do the request of him. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord indeed. From fruit trees to sea monsters and everything in between, all creation owes thanks and praise to God. It may be a little difficult for us to imagine that an object such as a flower is capable of praise. But what the rose lacks in voice, it more than makes up for in beauty, offering a bloom that says so much about the essence, about the intention of its creator. All temperatures and allergies aside, on a beautiful day like this, a beautiful spring day, we're reminded of the visual feast that is before us. Plants, trees, and flowers are blooming everywhere you look. Wisteria, cherry trees, dogwoods, azaleas, and there are more to come. It's no wonder spring provides such a powerful metaphor for the resurrection. The beauty expressed by the psalmist was unimaginable just a few weeks back when we wept at the foot of the cross. Yet out of nothing, out of the darkness, comes the light of Easter, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And Psalm 148 provides a marvelous expression of praise to God. Voices from heaven and from earth. Voices of animals and angels and humans. Voices of women and men, young and old, all joining in worshiping the one who makes all things new. This is something that we tend to forget. One of the biggest traps we fall into is believing that what is will always be. God isn't finished with the world yet. And he's not finished with us. We too are being made new. The good news is that our stories are not set in stone. Yet we rarely give ourselves permission to ask important questions like, what will we make of our lives? What will we do with our energies? What kind of world do we want to create? We forget what Jesus said about coming to bring us not just any ordinary life, but an abundant life. Just as God brought the world out of nothing, the Lord is always at work bringing us through the difficult and challenging times. Like a rose dormant in winter, God is causing us to bloom in the splendor of his spring. Out of nothing comes grace, kindness, mercy, and love. The author of the book of 1 Peter writes, "Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. And the Apostle Paul told the Christ followers living in Corinth, if anyone is in Christ, if anyone knows Christ, if anyone's in a relationship with Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old is passed away. Everything has become new. Friends, how incredible it is to be part of God's good creation. To worship the God who can and does bring something out of nothing. The very God who created the world is the God who, through the Spirit, still provides sustenance in our lives. The very God who raised Jesus from the nothingness of death continues to bring new life to us, to you and to me. God takes the empty and fills it. God takes the broken and puts it back together again. Out of nothing comes something. And we are that something. Praise the Lord. Amen. If you are able, would you please stand? And let us say what it is we believe by using the words of the Apostles' Creed as found in your bulletin. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the
suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He ascended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
You may be seated. Now is the time when we share our joys and concerns with one another as members of this church family. I invite you to, if you are comfortable saying aloud, those people who you would like to be praying for or encouraging us to pray for, as well as sharing any joys you might have. I'll direct your attention again to the insert in the bulletin for the ongoing list of names that we keep there. Members of the church who we are knowledgeable of that are in need of our prayers, as well as friends and relatives of church members. Take this, if you don't take any other part of the bulletin home with you, take this part and use this in your prayers, your daily or weekly prayers. What would you like to share with your church family today? What concerns or joys are on your mind? Carolyn. Carolyn's cousin eloped in New Orleans, so congratulations to you. Do you know the young man? Okay. Very good. Good. Congratulations to them and to you. Yeah.
My friend Lisa, the one that went through the first cancer company,
yeah.
She is going to have some museums next week.
What's her last name? Okay, Lisa Chadwick. Prayers for Tammy's friend, Lisa Chadwick. We'll do that. Yeah.
My aunt Cindy's recovering well from her surgery recently.
Yeah, Cindy Chastain, Sharon's sister, Christian's aunt, Kason and Cooper's aunt. Yes, we're glad that she's doing better. Prayers for her continued recovery. Yeah. Others? Charlie. Amen to that. We will continue to pray for you, Charlie. Thank you. Yeah, Robert and Nancy's friends, the Garst family. Robert used to work with Mr. Garst. Their family's going through a whole heck of a lot of stuff right now, and the senior Garst that Robert knows this week. So prayers for the Garst family. Others. Elaine.
Well, for quite a few years, every trip I made to Arkansas with most of my family is we're all based on somebody being ill, heart attacks, dying, memorial services. So I went a few weeks ago and on Sunday. It was so nice. No one was sick. We just had a good time at the church for on Easter with my family. We visited with friends on the way back. This was really good.
Very good, good. Elena went to visit family in Arkansas, and she shared that for the first time in a long time, it was not a trip based around somebody being sick, somebody dying. This was just a good vacation and a good chance to spend with family. So, amen to that. Glad you're back. Let us take these to God. Most gracious and holy God, we come before you seeking your presence with us this morning. We are grateful for the opportunity to worship, to come together as believers, and to share communally, not only the burdens that are on our hearts, but to share our prayers and to share our joys and to share our singing. Lord, we are truly grateful to be a part of your creation. We are constantly amazed, whether we admit it or not. Whether we acknowledge it or not, we are constantly amazed at your creative power. As we look outside and we see the nature that's around us, from the blades of grass to the branches in the trees, to the blue sky, to the clouds, it never ceases to amaze us. Your power and your majesty. And then we look in the faces of one another, and again, we are grateful for your creation. Lord, help us to remember in times of disagreement that the person that we are talking to, the person that we're sitting across the table from, help us to remember that they are your creation as well. We share that in common. Help us to remember that we are all related. We are all connected. We're all part of your family. Lord, you have heard the names that have been mentioned this morning. We bring them before you. You know where healing is needed. You know where comfort is needed, where peace is needed. We pray also for the prayers that were said silently on our hearts this morning. You go before us, Lord. You go before us, behind us, and beside us in all things. So help us to remember that you are there when things get too big for us to handle, which are most things. Let us remember to hand them over to you, for you to take care of. Lord, we thank you for the joys that have been shared. It is joyful being your people. You created us for love and for joy and for laughter and good times. And we are grateful for that as well. We thank you for this church. For 72 some years, we have been ministering in this community. And we are grateful for that opportunity. We pray that you would continue to inspire us, continue to lead us into what you want us to be doing, how you want us to be the hands and feet of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, we pray for people around the world. We pray for the people of Ecuador and for Japan, for the people of Houston. We pray for this community of Wilmington, for our state, for our country. And we pray for your world. Despite all the hatred that we see, all the violence, all the craziness that goes on, this is still your world. You continue to hold it in the palm of your hand. You are still on the throne. You are making all things new. And to that we say, amen. Lord, we close by saying the prayer which Jesus taught his disciples, praying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. One of the ways in which we respond to all of God's goodness in our lives and blessings is through the giving of our tithes and offerings. Would the ushers please come forward? Thank you. God of grace and love, we thank you for these gifts and the givers, and we dedicate them to your use, both here in Wilmington and throughout the world. Let all of God's people together say, Amen. Friends, I forgot to mention that we're glad to have Mary Knowlton back with us this morning. She's been away for several weeks. We are glad that you're doing better and glad that you're with us this morning. Friends, our worship ends, but now our work begins. May the amazing grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the extravagant love of God, and the ever-present fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.